Hello, everyone. Welcome to the Teacher Development Podcast. Thank you for tuning in. I am Saba, and we have Fiona with us today. We will be exploring a very interesting concept called the Green Classroom. Hello, Fiona. How are you?
Hello, I'm fine, thanks. How are you?
I'm very well, Fiona. Thank you for joining us today. We are very curious to learn about our topic, which is the Green Classroom. Could you tell us about the lesson on a Green Classroom, please?
Yes, I'm really enthusiastic about this lesson because obviously a green classroom means, an environment which is healthy and respects nature and things like that. But it's also about, the students being aware of where they are and also giving them ownership of being able to change their environment and make it greener, which might involve, putting differentiated rubbish baskets and disposing of the waste accordingly. Or it might just make it, mean making the classroom a pleasanter place to sit in. So I really like this, and I think it, because it empowers the students, and it's also inviting the teacher as well to think about how they can improve the work and learning place, which is very positive.
That sounds like a great learning opportunity, which takes me to my next question. Which classes can you use it with?
So this is directed at primary. It's A1 level, so, fairly basic level. Although I would say it would be for upper primary, so grades 3, 4, and 5, because the tasks required are actually fairly complex. So yeah, I would use it with upper primary.
All right. And would you need to adapt it?
It's quite a complex lesson. There are lots of bits to it. And I think it would definitely be more than one lesson, actually. I would divide it up into maybe 3 lessons, because there's the sort of learning bit, the input bit with the vocabulary, the grammar. Then there's also the sort of critical thinking bit about, thinking what the children think about what their classroom's like in comparison to other classrooms. There's making a poster, and there could be, follow-up for that. So I think, yeah, the teacher would have to think quite carefully about, maybe either cutting bits out or dividing it up to make it manageable in class.
I would like to talk a little bit more about the usage of this lesson. Which grammar and vocabulary points does it cover?
So the vocabulary will be vocabulary that they've done before, because it's all about words to describe the classroom. So, desk, ceiling, floor, walls, window, plant, things like that. So probably words that the children are familiar with, but you might want to run through it. The grammar, so they're talking about the same and different. So looking at a picture, this classroom has a whiteboard, but our classroom has a blackboard. So that kind of comparison, or the comparative in the sense, oh, this classroom is smaller than my classroom. So you'd have to work on that. And then in the making the poster, you've got imperative. So do keep your classroom clean. Don't throw rubbish on the floor, there's quite a bit of grammar. But then the other bit is the critical thinking skill. This is inviting the children to actually think about what makes a green environment. How can their classroom be more respectful for the environment, but also more pleasant to sit in?
All right. And what skills will the students be using during this lesson?
So a lot of speaking, because they will be, describing. So they'll be looking at these pictures and talking about them. They'll probably be, if they do the poster, they'll be writing. And then I suppose, if you're revising the grammar, you might want to do a little bit of written grammar exercise. But no, not much reading, really. So they're not really practicing reading skills.
My last question is a fun question, really. Which activity do you like the best?
I like the poster activity because it gives the children the freedom to create their own poster. But I also like the activity where they're looking at pictures of different classrooms and comparing them to their own, because they've got various pictures of different types of classrooms. But if I was doing the lesson, I would actually put in some more classrooms that are more similar to the sort of classrooms in Pakistan as well. So you might want to, again, you know, adapt that bit and contextualize it, make it a little bit more relevant to the context here in Pakistan. But there's lots of things to talk about there, and I think the children find it very stimulating.
Thank you for sharing this wonderful concept with us, Fiona. It was a pleasure to have you here with us today.
Thank you very much. Great pleasure for me to be with you, Saba.
Thank you so much, everyone. We hope you enjoyed this podcast on The Great Classroom. We will be back soon again with another exciting topic. Goodbye.